Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to another video. In today's video, we are going to be doing the owner's review of the Maruti Suzuki Ignis. So with me is Mr. Nanda, who's going to be sharing his experience with his Ignis. He owns it for more than a year now, and he's going to be telling us his experience with regards to the purchase of the car, where he bought it from, his experience after purchase, which is the service experience, and which variant he's bought and why he's bought that. He's also done a long distance from Delhi to Gujarat, and he's going to be sharing his entire experience of his Ignis and a lot more. So make sure to watch this video till the end, guys. And if you do enjoy this video, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for a lot of more automobile content. Now guys, before we start the video, I would like to request you all to also check out Mr. Nanda's channel. The name of the channel is Food Reservations with Mr. Nanda. It's a food channel, and they make a lot of videos with regards to Delhi food, street food videos, and also food that Mr. Nanda creates. So if you are into food videos, make sure to hit that subscribe button to his channel as well and do check it out. Anyway, let's get started with the video. So Mr. Nanda, welcome to our channel, and introduce yourself and tell us where you're from.
Thank you, Siddharth, for having me in your channel. So basically, I'm from Delhi. I'm born and brought up in Delhi itself. So I know the, you know, the road conditions over here, and the, you know, what are the latest, you know, cars which basically in the demand in the Delhi right now. So first I would like to, you know, share the buying experience of this car. Yes. So I have bought a Delta model of Ignis, and it is a 2019 model. I bought it in December, and this is from Nexa. So that was like, you know, completely different experience and the amazing experience which I had with the with Nexa while buying this car. They served very well, and they explained very well about the model, the features and everything, I guess, right? So, but yeah, in the end, I would say like I'm pretty satisfied with the service they are providing right now, and which they already provided while selling me this car.
So I wanted to ask you, why particularly did you choose the Ignis model? Like, were there other options in the market in 2019 when you were buying your car? Was there any other options, and why did you choose the Ignis model?
To be very honest, I have seen many cars. I had like Swift and Baleno in my bucket as well that time. But if you must have noticed, like Ignis has some height, right? So I always wanted some, you know, car in a budget who basically heighted one. And so that I can, you know, easily accommodate the things in their dicky as well, right?
Yes. So Ignis has a 180 mm ground clearance, and right, that is a very plus point, because the Mumbai roads, the Delhi roads are not very good. So this really helps. The ground clearance being a 180 is very good as compared to other cars in the market. When you were purchasing the car, you had any other car options that you were looking at, or it was only the Ignis that, you know, you fell in love with the design, or any particular reason why you chose the Ignis?
Yeah, as I mentioned, like, you know, I did put, you know, Ignis, Baleno and the Swift in my bucket while buying this car. But since the engine would remain the same in all three cars, right? But as I mentioned, Ignis has a good, ground clearance, and it's pretty wide. You can see, you know, there is more than a 6 inches, yes, gap from the roof to my head, right? And I'm like 5'7".
Yes. Yes.
So you can understand how much spacious this car is, basically, if you're sitting in. This is like, you know, nice cockpit when you sit in this car on the driving seat.
And any other brand that you were considering, or only was it Suzuki that you had decided on?
I think I was just considering only Suzuki brand, but later on I realized that Ignis is being selling by Nexa showroom. So later on we visited to Nexa showroom, and I think I have visited 3 Nexa showrooms, but the Parparganj IP extension Nexa, I think they gave me the nice deal which I wanted to just cracked it, you know, there and there. So finally the car is here, and they provided very, you know, nice deal to me for this one.
So other things that I would like to ask is that, if you don't mind answering, how much did you buy the car for, and did you exchange another car for it, and what was the deal that you got from the dealer?
Yes, Siddharth, I think this is a very, you know, important question, which I even forgot to tell you, that I have exchanged my Centro Zing, which was a 2007 model, right? And after exchange, this baby did cost me around 5,15,000. Can you believe it? That was like very, nice deal which Nexa gave me that time after exchanging my old car. So I'm really happy with the exchange value which they provided me, I guess.
Okay, and this is the Delta variant?
Yes. It's the second variant from base model.
So that brings me to my next question, is to why you chose the Delta variant as opposed to the Alpha or the other variants, or the Zeta variant. So why the Delta variant did you pick? Was that your choice?
Specifically, why did I choose this model? Because this model has music system, all power windows, and you will get the controls on the steering wheel as well, right? So I think whatever I was requiring that time, I got it in this model, right? So I think that would I say the reason why did I choose this model. And since I had some budget issues, I had only 6 lakhs in my pocket, and I have just noticed like this could be like the best model I can have in the market right now in this price point, which offering 2 airbags, one is for the driver and another co-passenger. So I think I didn't see any other car who offering this much of features in this price point.
Yes. So the Ignis has the same engine as the Baleno and the Swift, and it is a smaller car, means it's lighter, but at the same time the engine is the same, so the power is the same, so there's more power that you can get from the Ignis. It's the 1.2 liter naturally aspirated engine that produces 83 brake horsepower or PS of power and around 120 newton meters of torque. So guys, that is a very good engine, and it is very silent, the engine. Tell me some experience of your engine, like are you happy with the engine as compared to other cars that you test drove at the time before buying the car?
Yes, absolutely. Even this time I have turned on the AC, but you barely see any vibrations in the car, I would say. And sometimes I don't realize that car is already started, but still I mistakenly turn on the engine again, try to turn on the engine again. So it happens often to me in this car, because you barely feel any vibrations in it.
So the NVH, which is the noise vibration, is very contained because it's a 1.2 liter 4-cylinder engine which has been in the Suzuki lineup for a very long time. So it's a very refined engine, and many Indians prefer buying this as their first car because this engine is so nice and it's very comfortable. So tell me, Vivek, you have the automatic or the manual variant?
Siddharth, I have a manual one, but you also get the automatic in this, in this later variants. So, but again, in the Delhi roads, you every time after every half an kilometer or kilometer, you have to, push the brakes, right? And you must be aware, all the time in the peak hours there is a traffic on the road. So that's the reason I prefer to have a manual instead of having a automatic, especially in Delhi.
automatic
roads. Yeah.
So how many times have you got your car serviced, and what is your experience at the service center?
Regarding the service, I think I have done service thrice for this car, and every time I just need to, you know, call Nexa to pick my car up from my home itself, and I think they don't take I think more than 4 hours to get me my car back after servicing it. So they are very fast, they are very efficient while servicing my car, because I never found any, you know, issues in my car after it got serviced from the Nexa. So I definitely appreciate Nexa for this service which they are providing right now for their cars.
In Delhi, who is the service provider for the Nexa car in your area?
I think there is a service center in Padpadganj area, which is nearby Anand Vihar, and there itself the Nexa showroom from where I brought this car. So which is a good thing, I think, which is not, you know, too far from my place, and every time they reminds me for the service of this car, and since, you know, in the busy time you often forgets to get service your car, so which is a good thing, I think they every time reminds me to get service my car.
What is the cost of the service, if you don't mind answering, what is the cost of the service, your previous service?
Mm-hmm. So it depends basically. In the first service you don't need to pay anything, I guess, but I think in the second service you have to pay for the oil and the filter change and all these stuffs, and I think that was costs around I guess 6,000 to 7,000 for second service, and for third service, okay, I think we have spent only 3,000 to 4,000 on the service.
Okay, so that is not bad. As in 6,000 to 7,000 is a little bit on the higher side, but 4,000 is 3,000 to 4,000 is fine for a regular oil change and an oil filter change. Is fine, but 7,000 is a little bit on the higher side, as what I understand. Next question would be, what is the average you're getting, and how many kilometers have you covered in the car totally?
So if I would just check right now, I have covered like almost 12,000 kilometers in 1 year. And the average which generally I get is like 18 to 20 in city. And
wow.
I have visited 3 months back to Ahmedabad from Delhi. I think that time I was getting almost, 24 to 25 average in this car. So which is very good, I would say, as comparison to other cars. And I have saved a lot in this trip, so in terms of fuel, and I never faced any issue while running this car for this much of distance. I think the distance was around more than 1,000, I would say, from Delhi to Ahmedabad. And sometimes I had to, ran this car off-road as well, since there was some, some renovations are happening for the roads. So I had to, ran this car for off-roading as well. So, yeah.
Okay, so that is really amazing. So your experience that you did a long trip 3 months back from Delhi to Ahmedabad. So your experience overall with the car was very good?
Yes, absolutely.
And it was also giving you a very good average of almost 24 on the highway.
Definitely it will give you. And it was not my experience though. Even I asked, many people who owned this car, they shared the similar experience which I have been since last year, since 1 year.
Yeah. So Suzuki cars are known for giving very good averages, and because the cars are lighter and their engines have been the same engine that has been used for a very long time. Maruti has been refining that same engine. So everyone knows that the Maruti Suzuki engines are synonym for reliability and also very fuel efficient and mileage efficient. Mr. Nanda has been getting 18 to 20 in the city, which is brilliant, and 24 on the highway, which is superb. So thank you for sharing that. Coming to the next question would be, let's play a little game. If you had, say, 5.5 lakhs to again spend on a car today, as of today, 2021, which car would you prefer as compared to the Ignis, or would you still pick the Ignis?
I had definitely go with the Ignis again, because in the same variant, you are getting the back wiper as well, along with the alloy wheels. So I definitely would go with the Ignis again if I will get a chance to buy car. Yeah.
So that just goes to show that not only are you loyal to Suzuki, but also your experience has been so good with the dealer, the service center, and the Ignis, the car, that you will, even at today's day, 1.5 year later, you will still purchase the Ignis if given the choice, if given the same budget. So that is very good.
Right. And Siddharth, let me tell you, I have one Tata Tiago as well. But and I have live experience while using these both cars, and I definitely would say Nexa has done tremendous job on the their cars. And because in the Tata Tiago, after 1 year, I have started getting noises from the engine itself, and I think whenever I showed that issue to Tata Service Center, I think I never got nice response from there. And
that's the same response.
Yeah, they every time said that after 1 year of using this car, I think you get some this kind of noises. But I think, to be very honest, for me, it's nothing just but a bullshit excuses from their end, I guess.
Yes. So that just goes to show that Mr. Nanda's experience with Ignis, although he has one more car in the family, the Tata Tiago, he still holds his statement that Tata Tiago's cannot be compared to the Ignis that he has at home. So this is actually a very valid point. Thank you for sharing this. And I also know that you have spent some money on aftermarket equipments on the car. Would you like to share that with our viewers?
So let me tell you, I have installed one 1800 watts Sony woofer in it, which is very powerful, I guess. And I also got aftermarket roof rails as well, because since in 2019 you never used to get roof rails in this model. So but nowadays you are getting, which is a good thing from Nexa. But get back to your question. I have also installed one a set of sun shades in my car, which is a sliding one, and I definitely would recommend for everyone's, especially in summers, which is really effective nowadays in Delhi. Yeah. And I think some perfumes and some other small things in it. And if I would total it, probably I would must have spent almost 10,000 to 15,000 on aftermarket accessories. Yeah.
Okay. And would you like to share with the viewers where you got this accessories fitted in the car, and what was your experience in Delhi?
So basically in Delhi, you have a big hub for the accessories, which is Karol Bagh Market, But I have, you know, installed these all stuff from the local area where I live, basically. So I have got it installed, these, you know, accessories from East Delhi, which is Geeta Colony. You will get, you know, so many accessory shops over there. And I think you can go to any shop out there. They will give you the smart deal for accessories.
Okay, super. Yeah. Thank you for sharing that. So anyway, I think we have covered pretty much all the topics. Mr. Nanda has been extremely satisfied with his experience with the Ignis that he has owned for now more than a year and a half. And he's also done a long trip with this car, and he has only good things to say about it. So thank you for sharing your experience. Would you like to add anything before we conclude this video?
So Siddharth, definitely, you know, I would recommend for those people who planning to, you know, buy their new car and who have, like, you know, budget of around 6 or 6.5 lakhs rupees. So I think Ignis could be, you know, one of the, I think, the smart and the fastest option, which could be economical as well for you guys, right? So I would definitely recommend to buy Ignis for those people. Yeah.
So thank you, Mr. Nanda. Thank you, Vivek, for sharing your experience of your Maruti Suzuki Ignis. And guys who are viewing this video right now, Vivek has only good things to say about his Ignis. He has had a very good experience with the dealer, with the service center, and he is loving his car. He also has another car in the family, which is the Tata Tiago, and he still prefers the Ignis. And even to date, given the option, given the same money, if he has to buy a car 1.5 year later, he's still going to pick the Ignis. So thank you, Mr. Nanda. Thank you, Vivek, for sharing your experience. And guys, before we end this video, I would like to request you all to please visit Mr. Nanda's YouTube channel. It's fairly new, and he is dedicated to creating food related content, food that you would see on Delhi streets, food that Mr. Nanda creates at home. So make sure to give a look at his YouTube channel and subscribe to his channel, definitely, if you like food and if you have an interest in the subject. So thank you, Mr. Nanda, and thank you for taking out the time to share your experience, and I hope to see you again in the next video of us. And and also remember, guys, you can follow us on YouTube to get automobile related content, and also follow us on Instagram, and contact me on Instagram if you have any particular queries regarding buying a new car. If you want any consultation from our team, contact us on Instagram, and also you can contact us on this mobile number that is on the screen right now, and we will definitely get back to you and help you purchase your car with your particular budget in mind, and the best car for your choice. So anyway, guys, that's a wrap. Thanks again, Mr. Nanda, and happy motoring. Stay safe. Cheers.